books. They're really good. Anyway, a nun walks into a Mother Superior's office, and she plonks down in a chair, and she lets out this really heavy sigh with frustration. And the mother's going, "What troubles you, sister?" Right? And she goes, "Well, I thought this was the day you would spend with your family." Right? And, the Mother Superior says, "I thought this was the day you're supposed to spend with your family." And the sister goes, "Yeah, it was. I went to play golf with my brother, and you know that I was quite a talented golfer before I devoted myself to this life." Right? And the mother says, "Yes, I seem to recall that." The mother agreed. So the mother goes, "So I take it that your day of recreation was not relaxing." And the sister said, "Well, far from it. In fact, I even took the Lord's name in vain." Ah! Mother Superior goes, "Goodness, sisters, you must tell me all about it." Okay, well, the nun goes, "Okay, we're on the 15th, right? This hole is a monster, Mother Superior. 540-yard far, and it was a par 5, right? 540 yards. So anyway, and it was a nasty dog leg to the left with a hidden green, right? And I hit the drive of my life. I mean, I creamed it, the sweetest thing I ever made, right? It's flying straight and true, right along the line I wanted, and it hits a bird mid-flight. Bam. "Oh, my," said Mother. "How unfortunate, but surely they didn't make you blaspheme, sister." And the nun goes, no, it wasn't. Okay, now while I was still trying to fathom what happened, the squirrel runs out of the woods, grabs my ball, and runs down the fairway. "Oh," Mother Superior said, "that would have made me blaspheme." And the sister said, "Well, it didn't, Mother." And I was so proud of myself while I was pondering whether this was a sign from God. This hawk swoops out of the sky, grabs a squirrel, and flies off with my ball still clutching its paws. Right? And then the Mother Superior goes, "Oh, so that's when you cursed." Right, said the mother. And the nun goes, "Nope, that wasn't it either." Right? Because as the hawk started to fly out of sight, the squirrel started struggling. The hawk dropped him right there on the green, and the ball popped out of his paws, and it rolled 18 inches from the cup. The Mother Superior sat back in her chair, folded her arms across her chest, fixed a stare on the sister, and she said, "You missed the fucking putt, didn't you?" All that luck. Like, you could have had a double eagle on a par 5, and you fucking blew it. Oh, man. Anyway, Snope's still not here? Okay, I'm going to tell some more jokes. And who keeps running around here? This is Mystic Resident. It's got a little...
He's a new avatar.
He's not indoors. You're talking about the one that is masked and possibly a griefer?
Could be.
No, they're not griefers. I know them. They're not griefers. I invited them.
He can't enjoy it. He can't enjoy the show.
Yeah, he doesn't
know how to move around right yet. Just right, click on that. Click on that pink chair there, pink and yellow chair.
He's only four years old. He's not in voice.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, he can't enjoy the show if he's not in voice.
Yeah.
I don't know the Mystic guy. I don't know who that is. I didn't fight that.
Oh, Sonova's back. All right. Well, I'm going to kill some more time, and hopefully Sonova will be able to tell some jokes. All right, so. I called the cops about a murder on my front lawn, and they just hung up on me. Sons of bitches.
Mm.
They told me that we can't do anything about the crows. Stop calling.
Oh, I like that.
Okay, so of course it's Thinker and the teacher who gets the context of that joke right away. Why not Thinker left?
I got it.
Everybody else has to think. Okay, Tindy gets it because Tindy knows a lot of trivia.
I got a C. Good. Yeah. Good.
A murder of crows. That's what a group of crows is called. A murder of crows. The crucifixion. Right? He's nailed up there. There's Romans all around. There's Mary and Joseph and all the other disciples hanging around, crying their eyes out.
There's a Catboy with a spear.
Right. Oh, Catboy with a spear, right. But anyway, Peter's nearby. Jesus calls out to Peter, and he says, "Peter, come to me, please." Well, Peter rushes forward, and he's immediately beaten back by the Roman soldiers. And they beat him senseless, and they leave him in a heap on the side of the road. Peter wakens up from his beating and hears Jesus again saying, "Peter, come to me. I need you." But once again, Peter rushes the soldiers, and he's beaten badly again. Two broken ribs, three broken fingers this time, and he's thrown in a heap on the side of the road. And a few minutes later, Peter again hears Jesus call out, say, Peter, please, I need to tell you. Right? And Peter rushes forward, he beats the soldiers again, and he fights a savage fight, and he's beaten and bloody. But this time, he makes it to the foot of the cross, Jesus is hanging. And he calls out, he says, Jesus, I am here. What do you need to tell me? Peter just cries to his Savior. And Jesus looks down at him and says, dude, I could totally see your house from up here.
So wrong, it's good.
Alaska from my back porch.
Yeah. I can see your house from up here, man. It's awesome. Anyway. You want to hear wrong. Here, this one's wrong. This is a short one. I'm going to do this one, and then I'm going to move on to Braden. All right? This Please. One is a mother is scolding her son, right? She's yelling at him. She says, your teacher called me today, and she told me that you use the C word in class. Is that true? The little boy goes, yes, Mom. That wasn't clever now, was it? He said, no, Mom, it was cunt.